Okay, so this is Citadel, and this is what we're going to be playing for our Let's Play. So I've played a little bit of it before, and it was really good. So I just wanted to sort of get a feel for the game, and I enjoyed it. I didn't want to like jump into a Let's Play. This is my first ever Let's Play, and I didn't want to just jump into that without like having experienced the game a bit before and know if I enjoyed it or not. So this is the server I was on. It seems to be the only official server in Europe. I'm in Europe, so if you hide the custom ones, this is the only one. Let me see. We've got these ones, Europe, but this is the only one that seems to have any active players on, and it's PvE in Europe. So this is the one I was on. I deleted my character so that I could start over for the Let's Play. So we'll see how this goes. This should be quite fun. Let me know if you guys have played this Citadel Forged with Fire. I'm enjoying it. It is like the survival elements are very similar to Ark, except you're using magic. I'm really looking forward to this. Okay, here we are in the character creation. So I'm going to want to be a lady. So let's change that straight off. Here we go. All right, let's choose our head. Oh, that's a nice head. I'm not keen on that one. I think I prefer that one. Yeah, I think that's my favourite one. What hair have we got? I'd like to have some hair. Okay, I like long hair. I like long hair. Nice feminine lady. There we go. Head size, that's fine. I don't want her head to be too big. How do I change the hair colour? Ah, there we go. Right, skin colour. Let's give her a bit of a tan. Make her nice and healthy. My last character was like purple, and it looked pretty cool, but I think I'll go for something a little more. Just like a regular human character this time. Hair colours. Let's see. Oh, it looks a bit too yellow. Oh, I quite like that. Like pure white. That looks pretty cool. As for the nails, they can stay as they are. But I want some like crazy ass eyes. I quite like red. She looks like Bloodraven, the Targaryen. Oh, I had a name like ready, but I might go with Bloodraven. Bloodraven is one of my favourite characters in the Game of Thrones lore. I don't know if any of you will have know who he is, but in like one of the later seasons, you know when like Bran Stark, I'm talking about the TV series now, meets the guy in the tree. That in the book is Bloodraven. So Bloodraven is awesome. Yeah, I think we're all set. I like that. I like that a lot. I'm not going to change her body shape or anything. She's fine as she is. Right, Bloodraven. Sweet. Okay, let's begin. That is the character I want to create. Right, where do we start? I don't know if I want to go middle, left, or right. I think I might go right. Yeah, let's spawn there. Here we go. You spawn in like a lava pit, so it's a bit creepy. I don't know why. I guess we're born of lava. It's pretty awesome. Scary, but awesome. Okay. I'd like to play in third person. There we go. So if you want to play in third person, you just put the left thumbstick in. There you go. Yep. So we have quests in this game, so it's a bit different to Ark because there's quests. So it's a lot different to Ark. Like, there's a lot of similarities, but there's a lot of differences. I quite like the fact that there's quests because it just sort of gives you a bit more of an objective. Because there's no sort of dinosaurs knocking about to tame and stuff. Right, so he wants me to make 5 cloth. So he will give me some yellow pine for me to craft it with. Sweet. Except, let's do that now. So I have been playing Ark and Elden Ring in between since the last time I played this, so I'm not up to scratch, unfortunately, but he's given me enough of this yellow pine to create the cloth that I need for the mission, so let's do that. Is it done? Ah, I'm still waiting for it to craft. Let's have a look at these, because I ignored these last time and I was a bit gutted. Each player has an inventory where you could equip items, so yeah. I keep pressing start, but it's not start, it's the select button to go to your inventory. So you get your inventory and then you press the right bumper stick, right bumper button, and you go to your spellbook, crafting, journal, which is where your missions are. And this is like your engrams in Ark, so it's like your knowledge tree, so you can unlock stuff as you level up. How many people are on the server? So there's me and... who's that? But Carly, it looks like. So it's just me and Carly on. And there's your teams. So it looks like, yep, only four teams you're allowed. So here we go. Let's hand the quest in and see what we get. Ooh, 100 XP. Level up, sweet. I don't want to level up just yet. Like, I don't want to put my points in yet. What else has he got? Fresh berry salad crafted. Okay. So what you have to do is pick up berries. So very similar to other survival games where you just have to like grab stuff off the ground. I'll take the rune crystal as well. These rune crystals are used for everything, I noticed. Where are the berries at? Do I have to venture like out of the grounds to get them? So I can't see any here. Each player has a spellbook. Yes, I know that. And these, while you're in like the starting area here is a safe zone. You see there's like a bubble over the top of it. This is a safe zone, so you won't get attacked by anything in here. And I imagine there's probably no PvP in here if you're on a PvP server as well. So right, let me just go and talk to this guy again, because he was talking about making this berry salad. Is he telling me to go and actually pick my berries? I sound really lazy saying that, yeah? Is he trying to tell me to go and pick berries? Like a scavenger? Ah, no, he has given me the resources. Sweet. Okay. Ah, yeah, okay, now. So this is coming up here and telling me, do I want to add, asking me where I want to add my attribute points from my level up. So if you press back out of that, I didn't know for ages. I was like, well, where do I level up if I can't? I couldn't find it, but if you go to your, you know, your clothing section here, you go down, there's your attribute points there. So I have watched a couple of videos while I was playing it last, and someone said, and he seems quite knowledgeable about the game, he said not to level mana, but I can't imagine a mage not leveling mana, but I'm gonna have a go at what he said, and if I struggle, then I'll put any later points into it, but for now, let's get some extra carrying capacity. Because weight is always really, really helpful. Alright, equip my hat. Oh, look at that. Looking good. Oh, I was meant to be making a berry salad. I forgot. So easy to get sidetracked, yeah? So where would it be? There we are. Be under the potions in crafting. There we go, craft that. And I think the fresh berry salad is quite hard to say. I think it gives you mana, if I'm not mistaken. Let's have a look. 5 health, but 25 mana, so it'll restore your mana and adds a buff of 1 mana regen for 30 seconds. So that's pretty cool. Ooh, look at my reward. He's going to give me 5 of them. Sweet. I'll take that. Level 3 now. It's got another tutorial quest. Rune crystals collected, wood collected, and stone collected. So I've got to go farming now. And where's he asking me to go? Do I have to like leave the bubble, or do I have to? Can I do it here? The cave is empty. Have no fear. Resources regenerate automatically. You don't want me to go in a cave. I don't remember having to go to a cave before. The forest floor. All right, let's put this level up. Into, let's go wait again. Right, so you run really slow. There is no run button in this game, which is really strange. But you do get a run spell, like a haste spell it's called. So you do get that. It doesn't last like really long. Only lasts a brief amount of time, really. Stones. I'll pick it all up in here then, yeah. So I needed four wood, so I've got four wood. I've got the two stone, and now I need eight rune crystals. And the rune crystals... Where is he now? He's over here. The rune crystals are all on the floor inside this cave where we spawned. You do get, like, giant ones in the world as well. Oh, look, someone else is here. Huh? I think someone else new has just come in. That's right in the chat. Hi. Hello. Why is she running away from me? Stop running away from me. Come back. Be my friend, woman. Hello. That's pretty cool. So, who just joined? Let's have a look. Someone new. Lady Kira. Oh, that's quite cool. I'm sure people think that I'm a bit weird as well, because my gamer tag is like, it's a Dark Souls character's nickname, basically. So it's like it sounds like I'm a bloke, so when I'm like chasing after people and stuff, I think people might think like I'm some weird simp or something, which I find quite funny. I'm sure the people I'm following around probably don't think it's funny, they probably think I'm a bit odd, but it is what it is. Let's collect these runes so that we can get our reward. These runes are everywhere in this cave, all over the floor. You don't get many when you pick them up. Oh, level 4, we are climbing these levels. Right, let's go and hand this in and see what we get, see what the next quest is. Here we are. Oh, he's giving me a stone axe. Right, that girl's had one before me. Let's see if we can beat her to the next mission objective. Right, so he wants me to get nature's essence. Oh, he's giving me that. To craft the haste spell, by the looks of it. Right, let's have a look. Craft the haste spell and use the haste spell. Right, let's equip that weapon first. And then... So here's your spells. So that's like the second tab across. The first one, the standard one that you have there, looks like it's always arcane. So, haste, here we are. So if we create a haste spell, and then you need to choose a slot. These ones here is where you can put like extra additives to add to the spell, but we don't really have anything at the moment that we can do that with. I don't believe any of these can. No. Okay, so let's create it. I'd like my haste to be in this one here. Craft the spell. Here we go. Right, watch this. Watch this. Oh yeah, look at that. So that's how you run, basically. And then you'll have like a cooldown once the running stops. So you'll see now I'm running for a while, then it stops. And then you can see the bar just at the bottom of the screen where it's next to like the LT control at the bottom of the screen in the center there. There's like a bar going down and there we go. It's recharged and I could use it again now if I wanted. Right, done that, mate. What do I get? Nature's essence. And now with nature's essence, that's one of the things that you can create different spells with. So what's he got for me? Craft the extract spell. This will be my farming spell. Let's do it. So go back to spells. We use the nature's essence. Add to spell. So right, I want the extract spell because I want to do some farming. So let's pop that in this slot here. Craft it. Now we've got an extract spell. Am I supposed to use it as well? Not yet. Okay. Oh, he's giving me some light essence. So that's really cool. Because that's... Every time you get like an essence, it's something that you can add to your spells. So... Right. What do you want me to do now? I didn't speak to him, did I? Too eager to get playing. Use the extract spell and get 25 wood. Ooh, I get some ingot as a reward for this. That's pretty cool. Okay. Right, let's do our level ups before we move on. I would like to do damage. I'd like to level up damage. Yeah. By 2. And the next ones I'll put into health. So there's some trees here. I'm wondering if I can harvest these. There we go. So because I put it in the spell in the slot that I put it in, use right trigger, and then I can extract. Let's go back to him, show him what we got. I'm sure I got a wand for like that last mission, you know. I just checked then in my inventory and there was a wand there. Complete that. Build a fire pit. So I'll have to head out of the safe bubble to put a fire pit down. I'll accept that. Yeah, there was well a wand in here. But like, I don't want to go like too ahead of myself and equip the wand and put like make a spell on it with like say the light essence or nature's essence or whatever. I think the light essence does like healing, but I'm not sure. But I don't want to do that yet because what if like the quest in a minute is to craft a spell for my wand? So you know, I don't want to do it yet because if I jump the gun and then he asks me to do it and I've got no essence left, I'm gonna be screwed, aren't I? And as you can see, it's beautiful world. Look at this. Woohoo! That's gorgeous. I might as well do a bit of gathering while I'm here. Oh, wrong button. Oh, I get loads of XP for doing that. And if you look like in the middle there, oh look, she's extracting stuff. That's adorable. Yeah, if you look at the very bottom of the screen, there's like that green line that's going up. That is me, that's me XP bar. Right, so I need to craft a fire pit. What do I need for that? And this was, I found this so difficult. That's someone's build there, by the way. How cool are the structures in this? So cool. Right, you don't know. Oh no, I don't have a spell to kill this guy. I don't have any. I mean, maybe I could hit him with my, with this. Yeah, it's only level one. So pressing Y to hit. Oh yeah, it's giving me milk, light essence, hide. Sweet. And all I have to do is hit my pickaxe. So as long as you don't, I didn't have a spell on it, but I used it by pressing Y and it just did like a melee attack. Right, so I have to buy fire pit from the knowledge tree first then. So the first one, see the sword there, that's like weapons, jewellery, clothes. Next one, food and potions and stuff. Next one, building. So fire pit will be here. Yes. I have learnt fire pit. Can I build here or am I too close to like someone else? Too close to enemy foundation, if you will. So in order to get your building screen up, this was so confusing to me. So like you press left on the D-pad and then left trigger. And then left trigger again. And there's my fire pit, but I need some stone for it, so I'm gonna have to extract from this rock. Ooh, level up. I can't remember how much stone I needed, I didn't look. Get so excited to play that I forget to like read stuff. Alright, let's go. Alright, I can't place it here. Someone else probably got something built nearby then, eh? Alright, let's peg it. See if I can find somewhere up here. Is that someone's house? No. Oh, there's loads of nature essence up here as well. I do, like, I know I don't have to do these starting quests. I can't get up there. I'd get poisoned in there, wouldn't I? I want to do the starting quests because I like getting the XP and I like the fact that there are quests. You know? Let's get all these because these are good for mana potions. Right. Can I put a fireplace down yet? Oh, there we are. Yeah! Okay. So I've built a fire pit. Let's go back. Let's see what he says. See, I tried to use haste again, but it's on cooldown. Do some farming on the way. Go, go, go! Oh, I could do with a new outfit, yeah. This is proper shabby. But the, I was like going down the route of like the witchy looking clothes because I really obviously want, I'm playing as like a sorcerer, so I wanted like a sorcerer's hat and stuff. I've come the wrong way, haven't I? How the hell do I get in there now? I don't think I can jump high enough. Nope. Yeah, but then the bloke that was doing the guide, like he was just like playing it really, and he was just giving advice as he was playing it. And he said that if you go down the leather route, it's I don't know if it gives you more critical damage, and also it can end up being as good as like the I call it flak because I'm so used to arc, but like the metal armor, because I did unlock metal armor as well on my other character. And then he said like that the leather is better. I only unlocked like the hat and the top, I think. So I think I might stick to the hide route this time. Yay! Steamed vegetables. You want me to do salted boar? To cook salted boar. So I'm gonna have to get some salt from somewhere. And I'm pretty sure I got some boar. Salt by the ocean. Oh, he's got some salt. So is he gonna give me the salt? Yes. Oh, I already had a bit of boar because I killed that boar. So I'm gonna have to go all back to my fire pit now, aren't I? Good, there was nowhere closer to be able to build it really, because this is gonna be a right pain in the backside. Going back and forth to it all the time, and I can't even remember where I placed it. Hey, look, she's over there fighting. I might follow her around for a bit. Nah, I don't want to be a weirdo. Let's go and say hi. I wonder if she's brand new or if she's played before. Oh, she's got a sweet spell on the go. What's she doing? I love watching people just like going about their business in these games, you know. It's the same on Ark, you know. I love just like seeing someone flying past on like an RG or something. I remember once we were playing on the Scorched Earth map on there, and it was well bizarre. Like you're used to seeing people on like Wyverns and stuff all the time, and there would be people like just on a Megalania knocking about the map, or just using a Deinonychus as their like everyday knockabout team. It was really cool seeing people using stuff like that. Right, I can't find my fire pit. I'm gonna have to put another one down. If I've got the resources, I have, but. Oh, Christ. Right, you have to kill this. Oh, my mana has been used, obviously, because I've been doing the haste spell all the time and using mana for farming. It doesn't look like it's regenerating either. Right, salted boar he wanted, didn't he? Let's make that then. And then I can hand that in. Look, there she is, there she is. Oh, she's made like a an awesome spell. What's she made there? She's tanking hits from that boar. Oh, there's my. So yeah, when you finish crafting, you don't have to like access the thing you crafted in. It's like a little baggie that like comes on the top, like that. Okay, let's go and hand this in. Look at her go. She's played this before, yeah. She knows what she's doing. Ah, that's where you get salt from, the white rocks that are around the water. Okay, cool. So I should have some quite cool stuff in my inventory now then. Wow, it's filling up, look at that. I really want to use my wand, but like, I'm so scared that he's gonna ask me to do a quest that involves doing something with my wand, so I'm not going to do it just yet. Right, all the way back to the gatehouse. And hand the quest in. So he should tell me to leave this place. Oh, I haven't unlocked. There's like a fast travel in each of these spawn places as well. So I would like to unlock those. So I'll have to try and find the one that's here. Because the last time I played this, I spawned on the center one. Oh, yeah, I can get mana here. Just standing here for a bit, have a little bath. Look how quickly that goes up. Woo, full mana. Hey, mate, I've done your quest. I have brought you salted boar. Level 7. Look, banging through them levels now. Right, next quest. Ah, interact with the travel portal. Just talking about the travel portals. Perfect. I accept. I don't read all of the text because it's really small. The writing's really small. And it's a bit overkill, really. It's like an essay every time you read it. And I'm not about that. So I'll just like kind of get the general idea. And then just say, yeah, I'll accept it. You know? Unfortunately, this game, I don't see the Dino Lord playing with me, because if he's going to play a survival game, he's probably just going to play Ark, isn't he? Which I do love, obviously. It's my favourite game, other than the Dark Souls games. But I just really wanted to try something a bit different. I say a bit different, it's very samey. But oh, it's just got magic, hasn't it? It's like Ark Hogwarts. And that's just the dream right there, isn't it? I can't find the fast travel portal. Right. There is a map. How did I open my map before? There we are, down on the D-pad. So I'm here. The travel portal would be that purple tower. So if I click on that, and then look at my compass at the top there. It should have... No. It's not showing up. So it should be down here. Yeah, there it is. Look, you can see it on the map now. It should be down there somewhere. So if I just, like, totally passed it, I have, haven't I? Oh, here it is. Right, interact. There we go, unlock fast travel. So, once you unlock one of them, you can fast travel between them all. Shouldn't be much fall damage on here. There we go. Yeah, you can travel between them. You can't, like, go to your map and fast travel to one from anywhere, but you can travel between them, so that's quite handy, really. Right, what do I get? Nature's essence, salad, salted boar, and some cloth. I'll take it. Ooh, he wants me to leave this place now. I've got to venture out into the wilds alone. And speak with Gembok. Right, and where would Gembok be? Let's see, zoom out. Whoa, Gembok's miles away! Crikey. I mean, I guess we'll make our way towards there. What if we make our way towards this safe zone first, and then I can unlock the fast travel there on the way? Yep, I think I will do that. It looks like there is another mission here somewhere. Oh, that might just be his thing. Right, so I can use this wand then, can't I? Where is it? Let's equip that. And make a spell. I do want dark essence, is what I want. How do I change what's down the bottom there? I think it's X. Yes, there we go. Okay, so I want dark essence because that's the spell that I want, but for now I'm going to probably have to use this. What does this do? Adds 2% spell energy. So I think I'll use some of that just to make my spell a little bit stronger. And I would like... Oh, Roots of Wrath's quite good, but so is... Where's the... There's like a geyser that you can get. Perhaps... I was using a staff before, so... Bark skin, so that will make my, like, my armor better. Nature's touch. Healing. I don't want to be healing. I guess she's going to have to be Roots of Wrath. I wanted some sort of a projectile spell, you know? Oh, I guess I'll put that on there. Craft. Oh, arcane. Hang on. Well, this has got to have a arcane beam. That's what that lady must have been using that we've seen outside. Shoots a beam of arcane energy. Arcane missile. No, I want a missile. I thought that was the AoE, but I've been giving wrong information out here, guys. They don't really know this game that well, as is becoming apparent. I will put that in there. Craft that. And then, this is the berry salad. Make some more of that, because I'm going to need to replenish my mana. Why can't I make fresh berry salad? What do I need? Hey, if you click A on that as well, you will, you'll see what's needed for it. Crowberries. Okay. Right. I'm going to equip these. There. And what does this do? Will this replenish everything if I eat it? Just 5% of 5 mana. That's crap. This will replenish some mana as well. What about this? I think we'll leave it with the berry salad for now. We'll keep that. And yeah, right, let's go to the next mission. 1,000 away. That's going to be, although we're counting down quite quick, I suppose, but it's miles away though, yeah. Did I have a level up? I do. I've got 2. Right, we need health now. Health. Oh, 2 health. Yeah. Right, let's go. And I'll pick up any berries that I find on the way. Here we are, there's some here. Okay. Look at that. Big castle. So cool. Let's go. I need the red berries, I do. Oh yeah, I drowned the first time I went into the water. If you like, keep hold of A so it goes up to the top. And sometimes it jumps out of the water a bit as well, but it does stop you drowning, so. Yeah, see, I feel like I need to level mana because look at the amount of mana I've lost just from using like the haste and extract spells. That's quite a lot, really, yeah. What we got here? Take that, no, I didn't even pick it, did I? There we go. Is my mana even, it's not regenning at all, is it? No. Yeah, and this 1,000 marker as well, that's not even taking me to, it's not even taking me to the mission though, is it? Like, that's just taking me to the next fast travel point thing. So, we'll see how it goes. I might have to cut some of it out for you guys if it gets a bit boring. Because I'm sure you don't want to just, like, watch a video of me just running through the wilderness. Gonna have to set up a base somewhere as well. Not sure where yet. I'd like to go somewhere near where there's, like, iron ore and stuff and precious stones. So there's not many areas where those things are, and they're usually built up on, because I've decided to play on official server. But I just couldn't just play a single player. I like there being life. Like, you know, at the beginning where there was that girl knocking about and stuff. I just prefer there to be some sort of life on the map. I don't like barren, you know. You feel lonely in a single player, yeah. I did when I played on Ark anyway. Like, even though the Dino Lord and me were playing it together, it still felt lonely just being on a single player with no other tribes and stuff knocking about. Alright, let's extract some stuff from this. Some nature essence. Am I getting any? I'm getting XP. Quite a lot of XP, but it doesn't look like I'm getting any nature essence at all. There we go, 3. Come on, there we are, another 3. Might as well have all these. The XP's going up quite fast though, yeah? You get levels quite quickly at the beginning, especially, like, you know, considering it's an official server. It's not as grindy as Ark. So far I've noticed that anyway. Maybe like once you get a little bit further on, it gets a bit grindier. I don't know. God, what level's up there? Level 5. Ooh. Oh no, pressing the wrong things. Is that working? It's alright. It's not great, is it? But I bet I'll get a load of XP for killing this. Oh, my spell. How do I eat the soup? There we go. It's giving me a bit. Oh, it's running away. It's fleeing. Get back here. Haste. Go. Can't get away from me. It's not taking too much health off me either. There we are. Loot that corpse. Oh, bones. Bones are an awesome resource, actually, in this game. Because you can use them for leech. So, like, you could get health leech off them. Which is amazing. Because there's also a spell in it. It's a projectile, and what you basically do with it is, because it takes dark essence, it uses health instead of mana. So then if you put like the bones on it and you get leech, then you're casting for free. I learned this from that guy as well while I was just watching it. I was just watching someone play while I was playing, and he was coming up with like the best tips ever. I'll have to try and find his channel and then link it in the description so you can go and have a look, because it was amazing the stuff he was coming out with. Yeah, level up. Aha. Oh, what's this? Oh, that's an enemy camp. What level are they? Too high a level for me. I don't dare try that just yet. I don't fancy dying yet. I'm not strong enough. So I want to get to that other safe zone there. See, now if the Dino Lord was with me, he would tell me to attack them. But I'm not going to, because I'm a wimp. And I don't feel ready yet. I don't feel strong enough yet. I feel like I would probably die and lose all my stuff, and Lord knows where I'll spawn then. Although, maybe I'll actually spawn at that, but I don't want to lose my stuff. I've got a fair bit of stuff now. Look at that. I'm Skyriming my way up this hill here now. This is not the best way to go about it, I don't think, but... Oh, crikey. Come on, get... Damn, what if I haste and then try and... There's got to be a way. It's gotta be. Let me up, please, please. I don't want to go all the way around yet. Here we are, path. More nature essence there. Is that boar following me? It is. Level one. I could probably take that. Yeah. You better run. Right, let's go. He's seen my level 9 number then, and he was just like, "Oh shit, I'm out of here." Would have wrecked him. Right, let's access this fast travel up here. And then I can actually get onto the main mission then. And then I'll find a place to set up a base, I think. Heathcliff. It's me, I'm Kathy, I've come home now. So cool, let me into your window. It's Wuthering Heights. I don't know if you guys... probably wouldn't know that. Mum used to me watch this old black and white film when I was little. It was called Wuthering Heights, and it had Laurence Olivier in it. She loved it. I actually grew to enjoy it because I had to watch it so many times. I think it's based on the Bronte sisters, Cathy and Heathcliff. I don't know. There we go. We've unlocked that fast travel now, so we've got two fast travel points unlocked. I'm not sure about this guy. I mean, I'll speak to him, but looks a bit dodgy. Whoa, look at the reward on that. Speak with Shadow in Umbrus. Level 60, yeah, I ain't gonna be doing that anytime soon. I think I'll accept the quest though, and then like, I'll keep it in my log, and then when I come back to, when I'm like a really high level, I'll be all, oh, I can go do that quest now. But, until then, where was my quest? God, it is still miles away, that, isn't it? Right, so I'm here. This lake here, there's iron ore around that, and there's precious stones. So, I know it's quite early to be like thinking out where to build a base. I'm gonna go check it out on the way to the mission. So I'll put a little marker down here, because it is on the way as well. It's over there. Okay, let's go. Pegging it on it. Now there is another quest giver. There's a quest giver at each of these. I don't know if it's at each of them, but I'm assuming it is, because last time I visited one, after I'd spawned at another one, there was another quest giver. And it was the same quest as the beginning quest, so I'm not going to be doing that. Oh, look, that's someone's build there. That's pretty cool. Some of the stuff that you can build on this is awesome. The building pieces look insane. I never unlocked anything like past stone. So, and I feel like I wasted a lot of engrams on my first character that I made on here. So Hopefully I can rectify those mistakes. Go, go. Ooh, eat the berry soup. I'm gonna have to make some more berry soup as well, actually. Next time my haste runs out, I'll make some more. Because my mana is going down. Big wood base. They've been expanding, by the looks of it. Looks like they've built something, and then, hang on. That's a bit weird, because, like, in this game, I think they've done it really well. What they do is, you put a throne down on your floor. Oh, crikey, when did that come in? So you put a throne down on your floor, and anything else that's connected to the structure that the throne is on counts as yours, if that makes sense. So I guess, like, in PvP, what would happen is you would try and get to that person's throne, and then once you've wrecked their throne, you put your own throne down, you own all their stuff. So it's like everything connected to that you can build your own sort of things on. So you can't just have like little buildings everywhere, otherwise they will degrade, which I think is really, really good. Like, you can't sort of, you know, like on Ark, if you render it in, it just doesn't degrade. Yeah? It's not the same on this. So I think it's a really good way of doing things. You can get like a temporary throne as well, which on the temporary throne, you just use it for like an outpost sort of thing. So I've not tried it yet, to be honest with you. I did unlock it just, but I didn't actually have a chance to try it out. But it sounds pretty cool, because then you don't have like pillar spam everywhere. Like on Ark, when you get your pillar spam, you know, when people are just trying to hog the land and stuff. So I think it's a really good way of doing things. Oh my god, this marker thing, this map is insane. You see my marker, it's just, I tap it once and it just goes flying everywhere. Right, so that's my mission there. Right, let's go to the mission marker. Oh, I'm on the wrong weapon. Although that does look like a pretty cool spell. It's like a, what did the Dino Lord call it? Forest Titan type spell. Here he is. Alright, XP please. Achieve level 10. Oh, I'm close to that. So, do I get from crafting in my inventory? Doesn't look like it. Doesn't look like it at all. Right, we've got some camps nearby. Why isn't it letting me look at my map? But feeling they're going to be too high a level. Well, we can but try. Let's go and have a look. I've got the chat up by accident now and I don't know how to get rid of it. Which is a bit annoying, so that's just going to be there now, I guess. Am I getting nearer it? Yes, so if I go down here, it should be... Oh, I did see one, actually. It looked like one of those ones that has fairies in it, and they're usually really tough. Let's see what level they are. Let's get a bit closer. Level 9. Oh, I don't know. I'm going for it. Oh my god, I'm not doing much damage to them at all. They're going to kill me, aren't they? Maybe not. Oh, no, they are. I have nothing to heal myself with. Right, I'm gonna have to peg it. Go, haste. Why can't I've got enough mana. Quick, no. I knew it. I knew I wasn't ready for that. Are they still following me? Christ, they are. Go away. Leave me alone. What if I hit it with this? Come on. Oh, it's a duel of the fates, this, isn't it? There we go. Whew! Alright, I did it. Oh, I got loads of XP for that, actually. Have I got anything that I can heal with? Alright, let's eat the steamed vegetables. I did a bit of health, but not much. Five health. What does the milk do? 5 health. What about, oh, salted boar, 30 health. Right, let's equip that and then eat some of that. Maybe I can kill another fairy. Actually, let's, oh, there's another camp down there, look. Let's do a little bit of farming. Just to get the XP I need to reach level 10. Let's farm these runes here. That's not as much XP as I've been used to. I got more XP when we were farming those the essence things, which I feel like I did see some essence things down the road here, but I can't remember where. Right, we're getting closer now. Any minute, there we go, level 10. Right, let's go and talk to the bloke. Ding 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 ding. I've done it, mate. Okay. Boar's defeated. He wants me to kill a boar. Okay. Right, let's put that level up into. Oh, I got 2 points. Oh, what's hitting me? Bear. You're not a boar, you're a bear. Oh. Can I hit him with my. I think he's gonna have to be spelled. Oh, God, I keep pressing the wrong thing. I keep pressing like arc buttons when I ought not be. Like, eat the salted bear. Boar. Come on. Do you reckon I'll get a level up from killing this? Probably not really, no. He's only level 8, but I should get some XP. Well, that's a decent amount. So I'm looking for a pig, really, aren't I? Looking for a pig. Right, for a pig, where would I be? Let's go and check out what levels these guys are. I feel like I need somewhere to spawn. Level 12, can't do that. Should I go and have a look at those fairies again? There is potions. I should be buying engrams while I'm going along, really. Let's see. Alright, I'm going to have to buy wood floors, aren't I? Wood walls. Doors. And stairs. Okay. Throne. Need.
Welcome home, good hunter.
And... Right, let me have a look. I'm going to need these potions. I need the health potions and the mana potion. Broomstick! Right, I need to find a house. Right, that is it. Next objective. I know I need to kill a boar, but I can do that on my journeys. I am going to go and find somewhere to build a house. Right, so I think that'll do it for today's episode. And then I'm going to try and, like I said, find a place that I can actually build. So I can have a base to spawn at and stuff, you know? So yeah, I hope you enjoyed it, guys. Leave a like if you did and subscribe for more content. And we'll see you in the next one. Woo! Hopefully we get a broomstick.